Hi guys, I'm CaptRobau and today we're going to take a look at the recently released 1.70 and 1.71 updates for Video Enhanced AI. In this video, I will review the new features, mention any known issues, give some tips and tricks, and share my verdict on whether these updates are worthwhile. So, let's take a look at the new features. We'll start with the best news for a lot of people. AMD graphics cards are now supported on Windows, including the new RX 6000 series. I believe you will need an AMD GPU that supports DirectX 12 though. I don't have an AMD graphics card myself, but from what I can read, the results are really good. Also included in the updates is official support for the new NVIDIA RTX 3000 series of GPUs. It isn't perfect yet, but some people are getting these cards to run Video Enhanced AI well now. I expect that as the RTX 3000 series drivers mature, Video Enhanced AI will run perfectly on these amazing graphics cards. Improved performance is also mentioned. I myself have seen improvement over 1.5 and 1.6, as have others. If Video Enhanced AI runs slow for you, I have a potential solution later in the video. There's now also JPEG input support. That means you can load a set of frames in JPEG format and upscale those into a higher resolution video. If you want the highest quality output, using JPEG frames as your source is not the best idea, as JPEG images are compressed. But it's better to have the option than to not have it at all. Version 1.71 introduced exporting to the MOV format. This is a common file format for video editors, but I'm personally not a fan. It does look good, but it takes up a lot of space. This 11-second video is 250 MB. The least compressed MP4 setting looks just as good, but is only 231 MB. Topaz Labs has also moved away from using bitrate as the indicator for the quality of an MP4 export. They now use CRF, which stands for Constant Rate Factor. I will be making a video in the future that explains this setting further. The last new feature is that the Artemis model has been updated in the 1.70 and 1.71 updates. It should have better motion consistency, denoising, and sharpening capability. In this comparison, you can see that the 1.71 version does look a little better than the 1.6.1 version while in motion. It's not really noticeable when you do a comparison of a still frame though. Now onto some of the stuff that isn't that good about these updates. The big one is that the Gaia CQ model is kind of broken. In this comparison, you can see that the 1.7 updates CQ model gives a worse result than in the 1.6.1 version. Topaz Labs is trying to fix this issue as quickly as possible, so I expect to see a 1.7.3 address this in the future. Video Enhanced AI also officially dropped Windows 7 support. This should be impacting only a small percentage of users, but I thought it'd be useful to know for those who are still on that OS. Note that on startup, Video Enhanced AI will give a pop-up that Windows 10 version 2004 is required. It's probably fine to ignore the warning, as several people have mentioned it runs fine on Windows 10's 1909 release. The changelog also mentions that in the 1.7 update, CPU only upscaling is slower. I recommend using a good GPU for upscaling anyway, as that's going to be the faster option. Finally, in 1.70, EXR sequence input was added. EXR is an open source high dynamic range image file format. This was buggy, however, so support was removed in 1.71. I expect it to return in a later update. Now, onto some tips and tricks. If you're noticing that your upscaling is not going fast enough, you can change some options. Go to Process, then Preferences. If you have multiple GPUs that support upscaling, then you can use them all by selecting All GPUs. And the following tweak should help speed things up if you only have one GPU. Check the GPU load checkbox. Finally, make sure Do Not Download Fast Models is not checked. Then click OK. What does the Fast Models thing mean? According to DealMG guy, Topaz has separate models that are optimized for various input image sizes. By unchecking that box, you allow Topaz to automatically download that model, helping speed up upscaling that specific size of input source from then on. So, what's my final verdict on the 1.7 updates for Topaz Video Enhanced AI? I think these updates are great. I wasn't a big fan of the 1.6 updates for Video Enhanced AI, which is why I stuck to 1.5.3 for a long time, but with 1.7 I think Topaz Labs is back on top. There are a few imperfections here and there, but I expect Topaz to fix those quickly in the next update. Overall, 1.7 offers great upscaling output, lots of features, stability and speed. So if you were on the fence about the software, I think now is a great time to jump in. You can check out the free trial, and once you want to upgrade to the paid version, you can use my discount code CaptRobau15 at checkout for an additional 15% discount. A link to the program is in the description. If you found this video informative, hit that like button, and if you want to see more videos about video enhanced AI, be sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching and have a great day.